Hello and welcome to all in this video lectures series on 8051 microcontroller. We are discussing the serial communication in 8051 microcontroller. Till today, we had discussion on what exactly serial communication means, how this serial communication is supported by 8051 microcontroller, and the SFRs, that is special function registers, associated with the 8051 microcontroller to support the serial communication. So, as we know that when we talk about basic serial communication, then this SBUF register is one of the most important register that present, which is going to work simple as a SFR to support the serial communication. Whenever we want to transmit any data serially, that data transmission is done through this TXDP. So, to transfer the data serially, first we have to put the data into SBUF register, right? And through this SBUF register, the data is forwarded on the TXDP. Similarly, whenever we are going to receive a data, the received data is by default present on RXDP. So this data is first get copied into this SBUF register, and after this, it is forwarded to the required register. So in this way, the SBUF register, one of the most important register, which is present in 8051 microcontroller, and it is helpful to carry the data during serial data transmission as well as during serial data reception. The next SFR is the SCON register, that is Serial Communication Control Register. It is an 8-bit register, right, which is having a configuration like SM0, SM1, SM2, then REN, TB8, RB8, TI and RI. We also seen that for serial communication, the 8051 microcontroller is going to deal with this UART, that is Universal Asynchronous Receiver Transmitter, right, in which whatever the data is there, that data is transmitted in the form of frame, and this frame consists of actual 8-bit data, one start bit and one stop bit. Okay, so in this way it is going to form the frame, right? And in order to deal with this framing, always we have to select the mode 1 of operation for serial communication, and for that the configuration of this SCON register for SM0 and SM1 bit is 0 and 1. As we are not going to deal with the multiprocessor mode, SM2 is kept as a 0. To enable the serial data transmission, serial data reception, always this REN bit we are going to make as a 1. The TB8, RB8, we are not going to deal with mode 2 and mode 3, so that's why these two bits are equal to 0. And by default, the TI and RI flag we are going to set to 0, right? So as we have seen, the significance of RI flag, it is going to indicate that, say, the 8-bit data reception is completed, right? Means what? Whenever entire this 8-bit data along with start bit and stop bit is received, so that is indicated by RI, right? And we have seen, right? So when, how the data is first received on the RXD pin, first the start bit, then D0, that is LSB up to D7, and last stop bit, right? And in case of this RI flag, especially for this RI flag, what is happening regarding to this RI flag, right? So the RI flag is going to set at the halfway of this stop bit here, right? So here the status of RI flag is 1, and when the controller is busy to receive the data for that much amount of time, the RI flag is 0. Similarly, the TI flag is used. The TI flag is used to indicate that the 8-bit data transmission is completed. And how it is going to indicate the same, right? So as we know that first it's going to transmit the start bit, followed with the LSB, that is D0 up to D7, and at last it is going to transmit a stop bit. So what will happen? This TI flag is going to set at the beginning of this stop bit. Okay, so it is going to set at the beginning of the stop bit. So for this much amount of time, the TI status is 1, and when the controller is busy or the SBUF is forwarding the data, right, during that transmission period, the TI status is 0. Right? So this we had discussed earlier. So today what we are going to do, we are going to see the programming for 8051 microcontroller for serial data transmission as well as reception. So these are the steps to program the 8051 microcontroller for serial data transmission. So how the serial data transmission is done? So for that, these 7 fixed steps we have to follow. As we have seen, right? So important note, for serial communication using 8051 microcontroller, always we have to select the mode 1 of operation for serial communication. So what it will do, it is going to deal with 8-bit data, one start bit and one stop bit. And in order to do the same, we have to first configure the SCON register with a value as a 50H. So when I'm going to pay attention, what will be my first step? So first of all, right, so to serial communication purpose, I have to configure the timer 1 for in mode 2 to carry what the baud rate value, right? So my step number 1 is what? Configure timer 1 in mode 2, right? And in order to do the same, which value we have to load? We have to load this 20H into TMOD register, right? Because as we know, say gate C/T bar M1 M0, these are the upper 4 bit associated with the timer 1, and again gate C/T bar M1 and M0, these are the lower 4 bit associated with the timer 0. So upper 4 bit dealing with timer 1 and the lower 4 bits are dealing with the timer 0. As we are not using timer 0, these bits are set to 0. Whereas the gate we are not going to use, this we are going to use as a timer, right? And in order to configure this in a mode 2, that is auto reload mode, the value that need to be loaded is what? 20. So this 28 we have to copy into TMOD register, right? Then load the proper baud rate value in TH1 register, okay? So we know that the different baud rates that are supported by 8051 microcontroller are 9600, 4800, then 2400 and 1200. So corresponding to this, if you want to load the decimal value, it's a minus 3, it's a minus 6, then minus 12 and minus 24. And in hex value, this is represented as FD, then FA, then F4 and at last E8, right? So we can load either one of these values. You can put the value either in decimal format or into the hex format, right? So the specified baud rate is mentioned in the program statement when we are going to write the program, right? So any one of these, what we call the say this is a decimal value and this is a hex value, any one of the value that we have to copy into TH1 register to set the required baud rate. Then configure mode 1 for serial communication. So as discussed, how we are going to transmit the data? Simple, the 8 bit actual data, one start bit and one stop bit, right? So here, in order to do this framing, what we are supposed to do, we have to configure, right? Or we have to select the mode 1 of serial communication. So step 1, configure timer 1 in mode 2. Step 2, load the required baud rate value. Step 3, just set the mode 1 of operation. And this is done by dealing with what? SCON is equal to 50H instruction, right? Then start timer 1. Start the timer and whatever the data byte that we have to send, just put that data byte into SBUF register, right? So once I'm going to put this into SBUF register, what the SBUF register will do, it is going to forward the data on TXD pin, right? And we have to wait for this TI flag. Once I'm going to put it, automatically the data transmission is started through this TXD pin, right? And whenever the data transmission is in process, right, at that time the status of TI flag is 0. And the moment at which the data transmission is completed, the TI is going to change its status from 0 to 1. So this we have to check. So monitor this TI flag for the data transmission, right? So when the TI flag is set, what we have to do? First, we have to clear it. And if you want to stop the data transmission, right? So simple, stop this timer. And if you want to continue the same, again, just go to this step number 5. Okay, so go to the step number 5 for the next data transmission. Okay, so let us cross-check this with one simple example. So let me open the code. So here is the program statement. Write a program to transfer alphabet A serially with a baud rate of 4800. Okay. So what is the first step? As just we have seen, simple, configure timer 1 in mode 2. Right. So in order to configure timer, right, this is my first step. Move TMOD comma hash 20H. Then corresponding to this 4800, what is the value for 4800? The decimal value is minus 6 and the hex value is a FA, right? So step 2, I'm going to copy this baud rate value, that is FA into TH1. Then what next? Configure mode 1 for serial communication, and that is done by moving this 50H into SCON register. Okay, so move 50, SCON, #50 H configure mode 1 for serial communication, which is nothing but one start bit, one stop bit and 8 bit data. Then simple start the timer. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start this timer, and the moment at which I'm going to start the timer, right? So this data transmission, okay, the byte which is we have to send, we are going to copy that into SBUF register, and then the data transmission is there into codex, and we have to wait for this TI, right? So when this entire alphabet A is transmitted successfully by SBUF, it is going to set this TI flag, right? So I'm going to, then once it is get set, I'm going to clear it, then I'm going to stop the timer. In the sense, this program is going to transmit alphabet A only once. So let us cross check this with the execution. So let us check this. I'm there with this serial communication channel, then timer 1. Okay, and this is a UART window. So whatever the result that is transmitted alphabet A is there, that will appear into this UART window. So let us go with the first stepwise execution. So now, by default, the TMOD content are equal to 00, right? And because of that, the mode 0 is selected for timer 1, right? So now I'm going to execute the first step. So now the 20H is loaded into this TMOD register. Once I'm going to load this 20H into TMOD register, it gets configured as a timer in 8-bit auto reload mode, that is in a mode 2. Okay. Then the value, the FA, that is the baud rate value, I have copied into this TH1 register are corresponding to this SCON, right? So let us cross check this. Right? So we are here with this. So SCON is get loaded with the 50H. Okay. So now the next, I'm going to start this timer, and the data that we are going to transmit is now saved present into this UART window. Okay, so in this way, this capital A is transmitted, right? So as discussed, suppose I want to carry out this process repeatedly, infinite number of times. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to continue with this timer. The timer remains in the on state, okay, and I'm going to put this again label. Okay, so go to this again and just cross check what will happen. I'm going to execute this in a single stroke. So here I'm getting this capital A as a output, right? So in this way, I'm going to transmit the data serially with the help of this serial communication block of 8051 microcontroller. Now let us consider one more example, right? In this example, what we did, we have transmitted only a single character. But right now, suppose I want to deal with transmission of a string. Say, consider this. Write a program to transfer DKTE serially with a baud rate of 9600, right? So what we have to do, we have to transmit this DKTE there, right? So first, what I am going to perform for this, I am going to store this string DKTE at memory location 3000H. Okay, so at 3000H, I have stored this DKT string here, right? And once I have stored it, right, what I am going to do now, I am going to deal with the DPTR. So the data pointer is going to point out this memory location, that is a memory point, okay? And as total 4 alphabets are there with me, alphabet number 1, number 2, number 3, and number 4, I have initialized one counter, that is what R0. Then the rest of the things are as it is, means configure timer 1, then load the corresponding 9600, I am there with this FDH value, right, and SCON is 50, and I am going to start the timer. Then clear A, first get D into accumulator and just move that data into SBUF register, right? So here our data is present into internal memory, that is in a code memory, right? So first I am going to access that code memory with the help of this MOVC instruction. So through this MOVC instruction, MOVC A, add pointer A plus DPTR. Right now, the content of accumulator, because of clear A, it is equal to 0, and the DPTR is 3000H. So the addition is 3000H. So the data present at 3000H is what? D, right? So now D is get copied into accumulator, move SBUF, A. So the first D is transmitted to this SBUF register. Then just deal with what? Check this TI flag. Wait for the data transmission to complete. Once the D is completely transmitted, clear the timer, then go for the next, that is for K. So that is what increment the DPTR, because D is stored at 3000, it is at 3001, 3002, 3003 in this way, right? So I'm going to increment the pointer, decrement the counter by 1, okay, and just again go to this up level. So up means what? Again clear accumulator. Now the DPTR content are 3001, right? So 3001, K is present, so the K is transmitted. So in this way, this entire string we are going to transfer using this serial communication, right? So let us cross check this, how exactly it is going to work. So in earlier case, when I transmitted only a single byte there, but now I am dealing with a string. Okay, just cross check. I am going to run this. So output I am getting is what? Simple my decay. So in this way, simple, by following these provided steps here, okay, we can do the serial data transmission. Now let us check for the next, that is for serial data reception. Okay, so for serial data reception, the first three, whatever the 3 to 4 steps are there, the 3-4 steps are common, right? What is that? Configure this timer 1 in mode 2. Again, the steps for serial data transmission as well as for receiver, the first 4 steps are common. What is that? Just configure timer 1 in mode 2, configure timer 1 in mode 2, load proper baud rate value in TH1, load the proper baud rate value in TH1, then configure mode 1 for serial communication, configure mode 1 for serial communication, then just start this time, then just start the time. So here now we have to rely on this RFI. We have to check the status of this RFI. And when the data is received by SBUF register, okay, whenever the data is there, when the data is present on the RxDP, no doubt it is forwarded to this SBUF register. And the moment at which the data is there into SBUF register, the RI flag is get set. So once the RI flag is set, take the data byte from SBUF register to accumulator. And if you want to go with the next process, that means to receive the next character, just again jump to this step number 5. Or else just stop the timer. Okay. So let us cross check this execution too. Serial data reception. And one important thing, right, whenever I am going to deal with any data reception, the value is get received into ASCII format. Okay, let me explain you in detail, just wait. Means what exactly? Suppose the sender is sending alphabet A. Right, so corresponding to alphabet A, the ASCII value is a 65. Its equivalent hex value, when I am going to convert this 65 into hex, it is a 41H. So what will happen? In SBUF register, I am going to get a value as a 41H. And what is this 41H? It is a hex equivalent of 65, which is nothing but capital A. Suppose I am dealing with the capital B, what will be there? 66, then 42H. The 42H I am going to get into the SBUF register. Okay, so let us cross check this. What is my program statement? Write a program for 8051 microcontroller to receive byte of data serially. Okay, and now what we have to do, right? Put them, okay, for the reading purpose, I will rearrange this. Let me set some alignment. Okay, write a program for 8051 to receive data byte serially. Put them in P1. Okay, set baud rate 4800. So what we have to do? Whatever the data that serially received, that data we have to send on the port P1, right? So as discussed here, first step is what? Configure timer 1 in mode 2. So that I am going to do by loading this value. Say move timor comma hash 20H. So as mentioned here, move timor comma hash 20H. Then load the proper baud rate value in TH1, right? So corresponding to 4800, the decimal value is what? -6, or even we can write here as what? Simple F. You can write this instruction also, no problem. Move TH1 comma hash 0 FAH, because this is what the hex value, and either you can load hex value or the decimal value into this TH register. Then what next? Simple, configure mode 1 for serial communication. So move SCON comma hash 50H, configure mode 1 for serial communication. Now start the timer and wait for data reception.
once the TI is going to change, say when the serial data reception is in progress, the status of RI flag is simple 0, right? And once the data transmission is complete, the RI is going to change its status from 0 to 1. So what will happen here, right? So until it is 0 means what? The complete byte is not received. Once it is going to change its status, say JNB RI, jump to the here loop and until this bit is not set, means what? The bit is 0. So when RI is equal to 0, the same line is get executed infinite number of times. The moment at which RI is going to change its status from 0 to 1, it goes to the next. What will be that? Move A, S bar. Means the status, means we have seen whenever the data is received, by default first it is going to placed into SBUF register through this RxD. So what we did, simple, the data which is received, I am going to put that into accumulator, and the accumulator content, that is received data, I am going to forward to this port P1 and then clear RI, right? And in order to repeat the process, I am going to there with this. Okay, so let us cross check this. Okay, so now I am supposed to select the port P1. Now whatever the data that I am going to type here, that may not be visible in this UART window, but get reflected into port P1. So I am going to start the execution. Okay, so first I am going to type capital A, means first I am going to receive capital A. Corresponding to capital A, value I am getting is a 41. Say for capital B, 42, C, 43, D, 44, E, in this way, right? So I'm going to put now 1, corresponding to 1, equivalent ASCII value, the hex value is a 31, 1, 30, for 0, the hex value is a 30, right, in this way, right? So whatever these transitions are there, through keyboard I am sending the data in this UART window. So whatever the value that we are typing here, that this value is not get reflected directly into this window. So capital A in this way. So you see this transition on the port P1. So what we did, simple, I am going to receive the data which is given through this keyboard in this program, and the same is forwarded on port P. So in this way, we can use the port P, this serial communication block, for serial data transmission and reception.